Let me educate you on the fact that
a true duelist takes on all challenges. So I'll take you on.
You know, I often have to ask how I feel when I play Ancient Gears.
You're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck.
What's going on, YouTube? This is MetallicTCG coming at you guys with another deck profile for an updated build of Ancient Gears. Honestly, it has been quite some time since I've actually talked about this deck and made any changes to it, so I'm just going to go over the current incantation of this deck and just show you guys how the deck plays and generally how we win with it. If you guys want to be notified of any more Duel Links content coming in the future that is not just live streams from twitch.tv/MetallicAerox, feel free to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications. I would greatly appreciate it and love you to be a part of our journey as we grow on these platforms. So, with Ancient Gears, the deck is pretty straightforward. You want to summon Ancient Gear Reactor Dragon, attack, and prevent your opponent from doing anything. So, again, no hand traps, no monster effects, no spells, no traps. It's a pretty fun turn one. I'm going to try to win Glass Canyon kind of deck. So, we're playing three copies of Ancient Gear Reactor Dragon. We never tribute, so he has a paragraph. But the only thing that really matters is that this card attacks, your opponent cannot activate spell or traps or monster effects until the end of the damage step. And at the end of the damage step, the discard attack, you destroy one spell or trap on the field. So, again, that is amazing. It prevents your opponent from really doing anything during the battle phase. You own the battle phase. However, it gets better. At the end of the damage step, you can destroy a spell or trap card on the field. It doesn't have to be your opponent's. It could be yours. In that case situation, you always want to go for your Gear Town or even Ancient Gear Fortress. Again, it's super fun. It's super aggro. We don't play the fusion variant. However, I am probably going to build a fusion variant just for something a little bit more fun and more anime-esque. But until that happens, we're running three of these. We're also running three copies of Ancient Gear Wyvern. If this card is normal or special summon, it's basically Stratos for an Ancient Gear from your deck to your hand. However, you cannot set cards the turn you activate this effect. So again, make sure you set your traps before you do anything else. Otherwise, you're going to be feeling pretty sad, man. And then also, once per turn, if this card attacks, your opponent cannot activate card effects from their monsters until the end of the damage step. Again, just super good. It prevents them from using stuff like Kiteroid or other hand traps. We're also playing, again, that's only six monsters. That's all you really need to do because, again, we want to get Gear Town and Fortress resolving as soon as possible. So we're trying to do stuff like this. So we're playing three copies of Gear Town. Basically, it allows both players to normal summon Ancient Gears for one less tribute. Not bad, actually. And when this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard, you can special summon one Ancient Gear monster from your hand, deck, or graveyard. As you can tell, main target is going to be Ancient Gear Reactor Dragon. However, depending on what you currently have, you may want to opt to go for Ancient Gear Wyvern. The reason why that is the case, if you happen to have a card like Double Cyclone, you can simply use his effect to be able to search out Ancient Gear Fortress if you already have a reactor in hand, and then use Double Cyclone to destroy your fortress along with your opponent's back row. Again, this is very much a glass cannon kind of deck. We want to make sure our deck does the same thing over and over again, which is get this guy out as soon as possible. So, again, Wyvern is great, and so is Gear Town, but you want to make sure you know exactly which one to choose when and where, depending on your current situation. Two Double Cyclone, especially with the current format these days that we're headed into, back row and field spells are more prevalent than ever, so having two is really nice, because it almost always ensures that you're having live targets. Again, destroying one of your spells and your opponent's spells is really good because it just makes sure and helps open up that you're about to go off on that turn. We are also playing two enemy controllers. Again, this is very much an OTK-style deck. So in the event that I do get out Ancient Gear Wyvern and Reactor Dragon, in case that's not enough for damage, we can always use enemy controllers, sacrificing Wyvern and then taking over their opponent's monster and push for game, and use Ancient Gear Reactor's attack first to destroy any back rows or any other problematic threats. But again, it's also prevents your... You can also use it as a quick spell to be able to change the opponent's monster's position. So, again, it's also just really nice for that added protection. Because, again, we're only playing four traps. We're playing two copies of Fortress. During the turn that they are normal summoning, your opponent cannot target Ancient Gear monsters you control with card effects. And they cannot be destroyed by card effects. So that's really good. Having that protection is really nice. Your opponent cannot activate cards or response to the activation of Ancient Gear's cards or effects, which is also really good. Again, just that consistency of having your cards resolve are really important. And if this card is destroyed while it's in the spell or trap zone, you can special summon Ancient Gear from your hand or graveyard. Ancient Gear Reactor or Wyvern. And again, you can then use Wyvern's effect to be able to get out of search and then just go from there. But again, you're usually going to go for Reactor. So this card does a lot of things at once. It's great for recurring value, but it's also great for protecting your resources. So again, 2 is a good copy. 2 is a good number. We're also playing 2 copies of D-Spells. Again, this is just a really good accelerant in case you do not have access to a double Cyclone second target on your opponent's side of the field. And you want to pop your own Gear Town or Fortress. Again, this works out really well. We're playing 2 Johnny Mirror Force because there are going to be times where your glass cannon will break. So having this as a protection is really nice. Not many, from what I've been realizing, not a lot of people are actually playing Drowning Mirror Force. So it does give your opponent the element of surprise when you do activate this. Because when you do resolve and activate this, it resets the game state where no players have generally any monsters on the board. Because unless you're playing Super Heavy Samurai, they're probably not sticking to defense for very long. And of course, the Karma Cut. Karma Cut is really good just because it does set up your graveyard if you really need to. Because again, your graveyard is technically a secondary resource due to cards like Fortress and Gear Town. And again, it just gets rid of problematic threats. Like, this card does a lot of things in one. What more do you want from me? When it comes to the extra deck, again, we barely go to the extra deck. We don't really have any really good rank C. I don't really have access to any good rank 9s. Plus, Reactor himself just does so much work. Why want to get rid of it? But we are playing 1 copy of Gigant X. You could search out a copy of Wyvern if you really wanted to. You can also put Tin Archduke. You could pretty much put any rank 4s. This type of variant deck, it doesn't really have much importance. But Tin Archduke, Zubaba General, this has no relevance. Gaga Cowboy, Utopia, Deltros, because you can make it one way. And of course, Gaga Samurai. Again, just very generic stuff. I never go into the extra deck, by the way. Like, maybe like once in a blue moon. And of course, the ability that we are playing is Middle Age Mechs. Middle Age Mechs is a fantastic ability with this deck because what this simply does, it allows you to start the turn with a copy of Ancient Gear Castle. What Ancient Gear Castle does, it gives them all an additional 300 attack. However, every time a monster is normal summoned or set, place 1 counter on this card. If you tribute to summon an Ancient Gear monster face up, you can tribute this card instead if the number of counters is required or not, or greater to the number of required tributes. So, I really like this ability because what it does, in case I go, like, let's say I go first or something, right? The card will resolve itself. I'll summon Wyvern, get 1 counter on the Ancient Gear Castle. I'll get a search. I'll, you know, then be able to have, like, Gear Town or something like that. So, it'll pretty much be ready for me to just normal summon Ancient Gear Reactor Dragon with only 1 tribute, and that being that card itself, because Gear Town's going to reduce it by 1. However, another thing that also does have the fact, too, is that people can sometimes get concerned about what Ancient Gear Castle can do. So they might use some of their resources to deal with that, which protects our other resources. So it's kind of like a catch-22, you know? But either way, with that being said, that is Ancient Gears for 2021 February. Let me know your thoughts down in below in the comments section. What you like about the deck, if you play it, and if not, what build you're currently running. I would love to get some discussion going on this. But yeah, I hope you all have a great rest of your day. Stay safe. And again, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and subscribe for more notifications. I'll catch you guys later.
Fine. I have a few minutes to spare.